Welcome back to Horizon Zero Dawn. What are we doing today? How about we start off by getting that watcher first? Sounds like a good warm-up to me. Oop!
Keep quiet now.
I haven't used my bow for so long. I'm wondering if I should be using it a little more. Well, its eye is a weakness, right? Oh, look over here, buddy! There we go. Ooh. Machine core. Oh, I think someone else has noticed me. What the hell? Why did they notice me from like 20 miles away? That's so strange. But in any case, I don't think I know any more side quests around me now, so I'm gonna go to the...
I think I'm in the clear.
Yeah, I'm gonna go to the main quest after this turkey is done. Oh my god, this is so distracting. Everything around me is just dying for my attention. Okay. Yeah, what was ruins again? I don't quite remember what that was. Oh, that was the place we passed by, I think, on the way to trying to get the scrapper that stole Arana's mother's spear or something like that, but yeah, not important right now. Let's go ahead and walk over here and talk to Ross then. Is there anything else we should be doing? I can't really think of anything else, so time for us to go. Ooh. Look around at the landscape a little bit. Yeah, there's a lot of scrappers just wandering around. On top of the little rocks though, seems like there's little sections that we can walk on. Like that over here. So easy to get distracted. Goodness. Could we just run past entirely? I think so.
It's on to me.
Oh, come on. Oh no, it's the watcher too. Are you gonna call your friend? Be great if you didn't. Still got enough time to kill this boar. Yeah, it's totally possible to outrun them, so that's good to know. Where are we now? Going back up. Mother's Heart, this place was called.
Aloy. We must speak. So, it's time. Are you ready?
I guess so. Now's as good as a time as any.
Yes, I guess. It's louder than I expected.
You've never been so close before.
I guess everything's bigger up close.
Soon it'll all seem familiar. Like home.
I don't know about that.
Look for High Matriarch Tirsa. She'll help you. Any other concerns?
Any final lessons before I head in?
No. You've learned every lesson the Wilds have to teach.
It was you who taught me, not the Wilds. Not sure my bow and spear will be much help in there, though.
It is with bow and spear that you'll win what you've wanted all these years, Aloy. Answers.
Oh, crap.
There'll be people celebrating and feasting. More than you've ever seen in one place. No other village compares to Mother's Heart. It is the seat of the High Matriarchs, a center of Nora life, a jewel of the sacred land. Give it time, and you'll grow fond of it. As I was. Back when I was at the tribe.
So if we get accepted, do we have to live in here? I want to see what the first line was that I accidentally skipped.
What should I expect once I'm inside?
There'll be people celebrating and feasting.
Okay, cool.
More than no other... Give it time.
Are you sure they're gonna let me in?
I've told you, Aloy. By law, any child outcast can run in the proving.
And any who pass are made braves and are outcasts no more. I know that. But not everyone follows the law like you do, Rost.
Have faith, Aloy. The tribe will honor your right.
I hope so, but I still want to talk to you and everything.
I'm ready to do this. See you back home in a few days?
You will not find me there, Aloy. Here. Take this to... remember.
Where are you going?
Why are you talking like we'll never see each other again? No. No!
You should be with the tribe. And I will always be an outcast.
But I told you, I have that figured out. I'll come to you in secret. I'll be the one breaking the law, not you. You don't even have to talk to me.
This attachment to me will only hold you back. It's my wish that you embrace the tribe. You've lived in isolation long enough.
Not until now, I didn't.
For your sake, I must go where you will never find me. This is goodbye.
But I will find you. Oh, he's such a law-abiding man. I don't know if he'll be happy that I want to find him, or should I just understand that this is what he wants? Oh.
I see. I'm glad to have this then. It will remind me of you, of everything you did. And how you helped prepare me for this day.
Thank you.
Heavier than it looks. But the cord is strong.
May All Mother bless you, Aloy.
And you.
I have faith. It won't be the last time we're seeing each other.
Day of all days. I have to keep my mind on the proving.
Yeah, why is he leaving right before I do this? That's affecting me emotionally. Oh, well, I can't let it shake me up. Gotta do this.
You will turn back outcast. Or bleed. Your choice.
Make way! Make way! Braves, stand aside. She is welcome here. Mother's heart is open to you, child. Come. I assure you, most Nora aren't so rude as those idiots.
You're Tirsa?
Who else would I be? Come on now. I've been waiting for this day a long time.
You have?
Oh, yes. But for the moment, I must leave you. I have other outsiders to keep safe tonight.
You what?
Envoys from another tribe, the Karja. Come to observe the proving, and oh, how the Nora hate the Karja.
Karja.
But that's my problem. We will talk later. In the meantime, enjoy the festival. Oh, down the path to the right, you'll find an old friend who can't wait to see you.
But I don't know anyone here.
Try telling him that. We will talk later. May the goddess protect.
What is going on?
Karja? Karja? Karja Hunter Bow. Why do I have a Karja bow? Oh. Hmm.
They do this every year.
Oh, they're not treating me like an outcast for now.
I like this better than proving itself.
I want to see something new.
Oh.
My mother's.
Oh, I'm sorry. I wanted to hit the thing on the ground. I was under the impression that the proving was basically like a test that, I don't know, maybe the children of the tribe had to take to become a brave. But it seems like it's a bigger celebration than just that. Or no, well, that in itself is a pretty big celebration, too.
I'm preoccupied. My brother is ill.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that. Was someone waiting to see me down this path?
Time to be worried.
It may not mean much to you, but the high matriarchs work hard to keep us strong.
Ooh, what do they actually do? Keeping my hands warm.
This heat crawls.
Aloy! It's you, isn't it? Over here.
Oh. Who are you?
It is Aloy, isn't it?
Oh!
I'm remembering your name correctly?
Are you the old friend Tirsa told me about? I don't know you.
I see you don't recognize me. Well, it was a long time ago. Teb is my name. You were half my size when you saved me from a herd of machines.
I remember. You tried to thank me.
I never forgot that day. All these years, I hope to see you again. If you came to run in the proving. As you can see, I didn't turn out to be much of a hunter. I served the tribe as a stitcher instead, a maker of garments and armor. In preparation for this day, I've made an outfit for you. I hope you like it.
What's it going to cost?
Cost? Nothing. Consider it the thanks I tried to give years ago. Long overdue.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. Free sample box. Can I have this? He's a merchant. Okay. So this is what he's giving to me, the Nora Brave. A new Nora Brave's armor, stitched by Teb, accentuated by Aloy's own designs. Offers no extra protection, but can still be upgraded. Then we also got this one. These ones here. Silent Hunter. Well, let's just get this one for now then, because this is the one he's giving me, right? Can I even afford these ones? Actually, I can. Can't I? Oh, but not this one, because I don't have enough blazes. Not enough sparkers. Not enough watcher lenses. Silent Hunter. I can get this one. Yeah, light protection. This one is better than this one because it has effects on it. I guess I'll get it because I can. Equip. Yup. But this is the one you want me to buy, right? So I'll buy it anyway. I don't want to equip it. Do I have to equip it? I bought it, but I didn't equip it. Okay, cool.
There. Try it on whenever you feel like it.
Thank you, Teb. I've never had anything like this before.
Well, it's yours. I think you'll find it affords more protection than what you were wearing. Every outfit offers some advantage. It's always a trade-off. Anyway, I shouldn't keep you any longer. Head for the Matriarch's lodge if you want to find Tirsa. You'll know it when you see it. A large wooden building with an angry mob waiting outside.
Tirsa said something about envoys from another tribe?
Yes, that's what the mob's angry about. Karja visiting our sacred land for the first time in years. I'd expect to see some tomatoes fly, maybe rocks. Hopefully not spears. In any case, be ready to duck.
Cool. Thank you, Teb. So, let me check this again, because I did buy that box. Yeah, let's open this. Fast travel pack. Antidote. Blaze. Cool. And let me confirm that what I'm wearing right now is indeed... Yeah, Nora Survivor Light. I actually think that the normal Nora Brave one looks better, but offers no extra protection, right? So, yeah, this is the one we were wearing, which looks really similar to the one he gave me, but this one can be upgraded. Let's add an upgrade if we can. How do we do that? Do we have to go to a specific tab for this? Modify outfits. Yep. Plus 6% resist freeze weave. Melee attacks. Resist corruption. These stats, like all those icons there, I'm not really sure what they really mean right now. So it looks like I gotta be careful about what mods I use right now because I don't have the skill called Tinker, according to the bottom right of the screen there. Plus 14 stealth sounds really good for me though, because I tend to hide a lot, but you know what, I'll just leave it alone for now, or... Yeah, you know what, let's just do it. Sure. Cool. It doesn't seem like we can upgrade our spear, which is a bit of a shame, but... Whatever.
Hello, Aloy. What you have in mind?
I want to see if you sell weapons, but judging by the tabs, doesn't seem like that's the case. Okay. My resource capacity. It's 30 out of 30. Should I be selling something to him? So when they say 30 out of 30, they actually mean 30 types of resources, right? From what I can tell. Yeah. I don't really know what I'll need and what I won't need. So I guess I'll just leave this alone for now. Yeah. Weapons, not selling anything. Outfits, nope. Mods, traps and potions. We're okay for now.
Goddess protect. I wish you well.
Thank you. Ah, so that's the symbol for merchant. Good to know. I wonder if Aloy knows what they're saying. Because she never was really with the tribe, right? So maybe she doesn't even know the tribal languages.
Interesting.
Yeah, it sounds like she doesn't know it. Free box? Okay. Now we go back to... The Matriarch? We can look around for a little bit.
Why the call? Well,
I don't know what they're trying to do.
Arguing like a couple of children of the day.
Cool. Thank you. This one. Ooh. He's hitting it so hard. Oh, I thought those were cracks in the wood. Are we going back this way? Oh, looks like we're going up. Up, up, and up. I didn't visit that side yet, though, so... Let me have a
Aloy,
quick
over here.
Oh, hey! Hey, man!
Karst? What are you doing here?
Careful. Pretend like we've never met. I wasn't supposed to trade with outcasts in the wilds, remember?
How could I forget? And how generous of you to talk to me now.
Don't be like that. You know I'll be rooting for you in the proving tomorrow. Can't wait to see the looks on some of these faces when you win. And if you need any last-minute supplies, I'm your man.
So, Mother's Heart. I thought you preferred the wilds.
Well, man can't drink alone all the time, can he? Truth is, I get lonely once in a while. There, I admitted it. Don't think less of me.
I won't hold it against you, if you give me a discount.
You can't be.
I'm joking, Karst. It's good to see you.
Don't go soft on me.
You should be giving me a discount for being a long-time customer anyway.
I'll give you my best prices, I promise.
Fine, fine. Yeah, so this guy has a lot more stuff. Sling, ropecaster, tripcaster, warbow. Can I easily compare these bows with the one I have? How do I tell if it's better or not? I can afford all of these things, except for the Karja sling. Slow firing, but highly accurate bow. For long range. I can have multiple bows, I don't need to just stick to one. Low damage weapon fires elemental payloads, best used to put targets into vulnerable states. Ooh. Tripcaster. Ropecaster. Tie down machines to immobilize them. Attacking a tied machine will reduce the immobilization time. Ah. But attacking them will make it so that the immobilization is decreased, right? So, interesting though. But maybe I want to stick to what I have right now first, because I feel like I might get overwhelmed if I try to buy everything. The sling. This one might be cool. It's cheap too. Maybe I'll get one. Yeah, I'll get this one. Elemental bombs. Sure, why not? Yep. And I'll put it here. Probably should have looked at this before I bought it. Ooh. It's a good opener, but not good for stealth. Because all of them get pissed off in the beginning. Resources I can buy. Traps. Ammo. You got a box for me too? Thank you. I don't know why they decided to do that though. Like, boxes? I don't really like that idea. Yeah, okay. I guess we can-
Until next time.
Next time, you'll be a brave.
Thank you for believing in me. Tutorial sling. Okay. Hang on. What was I gonna do? I was gonna do something first. Yes, open the box. Ah, I can't take the blaze. Okay. Quests. The tutorials. Do I need to go somewhere to do this? Trip machines with shock wires. Ooh, I get EXP for doing that, so I should do this. And it's quite a bit too, just looking at it. Huh. But we're in Mother's Heart right now, so let's focus on the proving. Cool. We have 2 skill points. Anything to help us right now? Low profile. Further reduces your visibility. Move faster while wielding a heavy weapon. Critical hits. Chances for extra resources when looting downed machines. I don't even have enough spaces for looting right now. Healer? Lure call. I was told that lure is a better alternative to rocks because rocks attract everybody, but lures only attract one. So this is good, but I don't think it's essential right now. Especially not for the proving. Maybe? I don't know. Well, Yeah, let's just do this one, because I do use the melee quite a bit. I know I said I was gonna wait for 2 skill points, but now I just used one of them. I don't know how fast do we get skill points? How fast do we level up? Because ideally, what I really want to do is get all of them, but if I keep spreading them out, the points out, I'm not gonna be able to fill in any tree. By the way, why is this one... Why are these ones... Oh, it's probably because I don't have this one, so it doesn't show me the next one. Okay. Use that from the tools menu to lure a single enemy. Okay, you know what? Let's just get it anyway. Eventually, we'll have to get it. Yep. Still not showing these ones, though. What does that mean? Use exclamation mark from the tools menu. Guess I'll figure it out. Alright. Can we craft anything for now? Resources. Great. I need more boar bone for the next one. Tripcaster, traps, hunter bow. Yeah. Higher capacity is always good. Let me just try to craft everything that I can. It's better to use up my resources, huh? Because... why hoard them? There's no point. Even if it's for stuff I don't use too much right now. It's okay, it's okay. We can pick all this up again. Yeah, I think that's it for now. Alright. We haven't looked over here yet. Let me briefly...
Listen carefully now. For you'll have to tell this when I'm gone. In the beginning... all life came from All Mother. People, machines, and beasts, all were her children. They lived alongside each other in the comfort of her wild embrace. But some grew restless. Though they took of her bounty, they wanted more. These were the faithless. The machines had whispered to them, promised to serve them. To make them a new world, better than the one All Mother provided. A world of metal. They told the faithless they would do all the work for them. Feed them, shelter them, give them a life of ease, of plenty. And so, the faithless left with the machines. Only the true children, the mothers and fathers of the Nora, stayed with All Mother. At first, the machines did as they had promised. They built cities, great and terrible, monuments to their sins. But they would not serve the faithless for long. A king rose up among the machines, a machine more powerful than any other, the Metal Devil. And then the faithless served him, served the machines. That was not enough for the Metal Devil. He wanted all to serve him, and tried to tempt the true children away from All Mother. They would not go. They gathered on the mountainside to cling to her, and prayed, more devoted than ever. The Metal Devil raged louder than thunder. In his fury, he came to confront All Mother, intending to kill her. She struck him down. Forever. As you know, for his lifeless body is up there still, frozen in shame and defeat. The machines were driven mad by the death of their king, and their minds became as wild as beasts. The faithless abandoned their cities, forced to wander the world without the care of the machines. Only we remain the true children of All Mother. We built all this with the hands that she gave us. Machines are to be hunted. Metal to be used for scrap, for craft. But never to be adored. And we stay true to her laws, resolute in our prayers, don't we? For the dangers are never over. Still the faithless envy our sacred land and covet it. And year upon year, the machine's anger grows. Searching for little Nora boys and girls who have not behaved. What? Is that a machine among us now? No, no. These old eyes are mistaken.
I thought she was talking about me.
Listen carefully now.
Okay.
You'll have to tell this when I'm gone. In the beginning.
Brave got drunk and danced
and get down from there.
Oh god.
Bad enough you're drunk. Why do you have to go climbing houses?
You shouldn't let these Kaja out.
Oh, not supposed to go climbing on other people's roofs, huh?
Not enough gossip at the festival this year. There were so many
Get down from there, now!
Oh, look at the baby.
That's just what you want, isn't it? For me to fall on my head!
What I want is for you to climb down!
What you want is for me to have no fun at all!
Fine!
Hey, man!
Stay up on the roof all night if you want!
Yeah, I will! She can't tell me what to do. I'll climb so far up she can't see me.
So when they talked about the metal devil, is that what they're talking about? The thing that we keep seeing in the distance? Earlier, the lady was saying something about how the corpse lies on the mountain for all to see. Interesting, interesting. We learned a little background information on the tribes here then. And I guess, okay, a lot of people are talking here. Let me go to a quiet place. Right, so I think in the context of this tribe, the faithless are the people that we saw in the cave. Cause they totally seem like they defected to the machine overlord, so to say. Yeah, we gotta remember that whatever that story the lady is telling is, of course, slanted toward the tribe, making the tribe look good and all, but... there's probably still some component of truth in it, hopefully. Where is this? Can never have too few metal shards. Ooh. Whoa! Shard Gambler's box. Why do they have boxes? Wow! I don't think I can open them right now because I have too many modifications. Shard? 20! Shard? 7! Oh, come on. Yeah, I'll leave that one alone for now. I guess that's that. I really don't know why they decided to do that though. It's not like we can trade with people or anything. There is no multiplayer in this game, right? I don't think so. Okay. What's going on here?
In a moment, we shall bless the proving. But first, we have guests to welcome.
For 2 years, we have been at peace with Akarja. It is time to restore our bonds of trade with Meridian. These envoys come to us under a banner of peace.
Peace. It's peace.
An annunciation of gratitude. Killers
and slavers!
Yeah! Sun King of
Killers and slavers!
Hey!
Luminance of
hold your fruit, Nora. Nora Faithful, hold your fruit. Now, I'm Azaram, not Karja. So I'll put it to you straight. The 13th Sun King was a murderous bung. Oh, he was.
Sun King.
A tyrant and a monster. Raided my tribe for blood sacrifice, just like yours. My own sister was taken. I hated the Karja, but the 13th king is dead. 2 years now. Who killed him? The 14th.
Yeah.
Not because he lusted for power, but because someone had to put an end to his father's atrocities.
Yeah!
The message that this poor priest means to read is an apology. Straight from the lips of the 14th king. So please, can't you lend him your ears?
This guy's good.
Thank you. An enunciation of gratitude written by the hand of Sun King Avad, 14th luminance of the Radiant Line. People of the Nora,
on
the eve of your proving,
unknown device detected.
No, the Karja stand with you.
Same as what you're wearing right now.
Frames the stoutest trees, as those you have nurtured.
It's for
take
the goddess
their places
to judge the card,
among your brave.
Let's check out his ear.
We join your prayer.
He's wearing a focus.
But they
just
will
like mine.
Tall
yeah. So it's from Karja.
You're the only other person I've ever seen wearing a focus. Where did you get yours?
What? A Nora? Wearing one of these? That's impossible. Your tribe fears the old places, forbids them.
Who says I'm like other Nora?
Why, I guess you're not. If you've gone delving in the ruins of the metal world.
What's wrong?
Apologies. A malfunction.
Oh, Lynn? You making friends with locals, are we?
I'll come back.
Wait.
No. We'll talk later. Have to go.
Whoa. Well, I guess he's more hungover than I thought. Hey. You got the same trinket that Olin has on his head. Since when did those become fashionable?
His name is Olin? Who is he? And where did he get one of these?
He's just a scrounger with friends in high places. Now, he spends half his time digging for artifacts, the other half drinking or dicing. As for the trinket, well, I guess he dug it up somewhere. Just a weird old jewel he sticks on his face. I mean, no offense. It looks great on you.
It's not something that's common knowledge. I thought the fact that we saw that guy wearing it meant that the whole tribe had it, but clearly that's not the case.
I thought your friend was going to go down in a hail of fruit, but you really calmed the crowd.
Thanks. I wasn't sure I could do it. The Nora is still pissed with the Karja about the Red Raids, and who can blame them?
The Red Raids.
I wanted to ask you something else.
If you want. But I'll also be around after that blessing thing, if that'd be a better time to talk.
I never heard anything about Red Raids growing up. What were those?
Your tribe was at war and you didn't even know? Were you kept hidden away? Did you have overprotective parents or something?
I grew up as an outcast, shunned by the tribe.
Oh, yeah, I've heard the Nora do that. That seems cruel, if you ask me. But even an outcast knows about the derangement of the machines, right? How they get deadlier every year?
What?
Well, the mad Sun King figured if he spilled enough blood to the Sun God, it would calm the machines. Didn't work. But for years, he raided the tribes and took captives for sacrifice. My sister among them. The Nora put up a good fight, but lives were lost.
So what happened? How did it all end?
The Mad King's own son united Karja rebels with Osaram freebooters. And together we did the impossible, took back Meridian and killed the crazy old king. So now the son sits on the throne and it's a big improvement. Under Avad, there's no more sacrifices, no more slavery. People from all tribes are welcome in Meridian now, even Nora exiles. You really should come visit.
This tribe sounds way more advanced than my tribe.
Who are the Osaram?
Oh, that's my tribe, far to the northwest. We're good at three things, arguing, working steel, and brewing.
And freebooters, what are those?
I guess you could say we were mercenaries, you know, warriors for pay. Except a lot more loyal than that makes us sound. Avad couldn't have taken down his father without our metal and muscle. And now, some of us serve proudly as his personal vanguard.
Your sister was taken captive and sacrificed. That's terrible.
Captive, yes. Sacrificed, no. It takes more than a few Karja to finish Ursa. She got away, and now she's my captain.
Wow.
Captain of the entire vanguard, favored by the Sun King himself.
How did she survive?
Well, that's a story, all right, but it takes a while to tell. Maybe another time over a drink or three? Or just come to Meridian and meet her yourself. I think you'd like each other. You're both rather, direct.
You said the machines have been getting more dangerous every year.
Yeah. I don't have to tell you that, right?
First I've heard of it.
Oh, sorry. I just assumed everyone knew. Well, the way I hear it, 15, 20 years ago, the machines weren't always pissed off like they are now. When a hunter came at them, they'd spook and run. So it was hard to take them down, but not dangerous, so long as he was smart enough to jump out of the way. But then the derangement starts up and everything changes. Now, when a hunter fires a shot, the machines snarl and charge right at him. A few more years pass and they start attacking people on sight. Going anywhere becomes a major risk. And if that wasn't bad enough, entirely new kinds of machines start showing up. Bigger, meaner, and heavily armed.
Like the Sawtooth.
Yeah, 10 years ago, that one. But every couple of years or so, something worse comes along. Believe me.
So what's making it happen?
No one knows. And the machines, well, they aren't telling.
Has no one tried to look into the origins of this? Oh, that's still white. Should I ask about that again?
Tell me about the derangement again.
Oh, no, it's okay.
Well, the way I hear it, when a hunter... So it was... But then, nah, a few more... If that wasn't...
Like the Sawtooth.
Yeah.
So...
No one...
If the Karja have such a cruel history, how did you end up serving them?
The last king and his men were butchers. But the new king wants peace. There's nothing cruel about that. Besides, the Karja don't just fight, they build. Would take Meridian. Next to it, everything else is just a bunch of sticks and stones.
I want to ask you about something you said before.
Ask away.
Nice armor.
What else do you know about Olin?
Is he really that interesting? I'm starting to get jealous. Well, he scours the wilds for ruins, digs up stuff, and sells it to nobles. When he's not scrounging, he's scouting. Exactly the skills you want the man guiding your expedition to have. I've known him for a few years. He's a loyal companion, cares for his family, holds his drink well enough. I like him, but besides that, not much to tell.
The thing that he's wearing, the same as mine, that thing is probably making him a good scouter.
I've never seen armor like yours before.
You've never seen Vanguard steel? Well, let me introduce you. Ring-locked, impact-protected, sturdy enough to choke a Sawtooth. It has to be. The Vanguard are the Sun King's best. Life-takers and machine-breakers to a one. You might even give a Nora warmaid like you more trouble than she can handle.
With all that metal to slow you down? I doubt it.
Yeah, hard to say. From where I'm standing, looks like a pretty even match.
Well, thank you for all the information.
I should make my way to the blessing.
Yeah. Look, maybe I shouldn't say this, but it's obvious that you don't belong in this backwater. I mean, you're smart. You're obviously capable, and, well, I mean, look at you.
What are you talking about?
You know what. All right, if you ever visit Meridian, look me up. I'll show you around, make introductions. It'd be a whole new life, if you want it. Anyway, I have to go to that blessing thing, too. So, see you around, maybe?
I heard he'll ask
for Aaron. I kind of thought he was hitting on me a little bit in the very beginning already. Imagine. Well, the other man is gone. Completely. So this is, this whole thing. The Karja tribe. It's a little bit of a shock to me because I was under the impression that we were the only tribe here. And even if we weren't, the other tribes around had similar levels of technology with us, but very, very clearly, the Karja tribe is really different. Even their men, they look like medieval soldiers. So, a little bit of a shock for me here. Although, considering that I'm wearing a holographic headset thing, it's really not that surprising. We should probably begin the proving now. Everyone's partying, but what about me? Guys, please. Let's begin. Hey, what's everyone looking at? Anything in the sky?
We'll start the blessing when all aspirants are in place.
Irid?
Oh!
Expecting more tomatoes?
In truth, I thought they were throwing stones.
Stones hit a lot harder. You'd know the difference.
If you wish to speak, we should do so after the ceremony. I'd rather not hold things up, or do anything else that angers these people.
Not being able to tell the difference between stones and tomatoes. This guy might be a little bit sheltered.
Let's talk after the blessing. I don't want to piss off the matriarchs. Those are some tough-looking grandmothers.
Sounds good to me. Am I competing?
Aloy, take your place right there. The prayer lantern is yours. I made it for you.
Thank you.
Blasphemy.
Sisters.
Aspirants, before each of you sits a prayer lantern crafted by your mother. In her honor, light its flame.
Oh, and she made me one. I think Ross would be happy if I did it for myself.
This is for me. For all I did to make it here. And the answers I'll get after I win the proving.
All mother, hear our prayer. What is the child but a mother's hope that takes flight? A glowing flame that climbs the air, set free to the wind, sailing the sky till it fades and falls. So, from one to another, passes the chain of love.
Wow.
There's Olin. I have some questions for him.
So that signaled the starting, huh?
You never know. Outcast might surprise us. Lost traitor, after all.
Is it just me, or is her stew a bit off this year?
Is everyone gossiping about me? Yeesh.
Bast, bast, bast.
Hey.
What about Vala? She's strong. Blood of a war chief in her.
There's too many people around.
The outcast might surprise us.
Hello, Olin.
You know my name. Guess Aaron told you.
Why did you act so strange when we spoke earlier?
Must be this festival. I'm really not one for crowds. Maybe I should just turn in.
Stop dodging my questions.
All right, cool your fire. I got nothing to hide.
I've never seen anyone else with a focus. Where exactly did you find it?
In a ruin, north of the claim. That's our name for the Asarum homeland. Up there, the metal seams run deep. Steel giants half buried in loose soil. Forgotten caves that the old ones bored into mountain rock. Your eyes just lit up.
I found my focus in a cave just like you're describing. A ruin of the old ones.
If you've delved yourself, you know as much as I do. Go to those places for answers. Not me.
What are you doing here, Olin? Why come to Noraland?
Aaron needed a scout for his expedition, and a second for his drinking, that's all. Someone to stop the Sun Priest getting lost. When all this is over, I'm back to delving ruins, rummaging for scrap, scrounging up trinkets to sell.
So you're an explorer?
Just another outlander, girl. A man's gotta make his shards. I just make mine in service to the King's court. That's all.
When we spoke earlier, you winced, then looked like you were in pain. Or frightened. Did your focus show you something?
It didn't show me anything. I told you. It malfunctioned. Happens all the time.
Maybe he got a bad one. I do think he's lying, though.
You're not a very convincing liar.
Do you always accuse people you've just met of lying?
Only the ones who aren't telling the truth.
Fire and spit, girl. I'm a plain hammered man with nothing to hide. You don't believe me, that's your trouble, not mine.
He's angry. Whoa, what's this accusatory? I expected more of you? Well, it's not like I can choose anything else.
I don't understand. We have this device in common, but you can't wait to stop talking to me.
I already have all the friends I need, girl. I don't need the bother.
I'm used to being shunned by the tribe. I thought you'd be different.
It's nothing personal. It really isn't. You should try to enjoy yourself tonight. Big day tomorrow. Always best to make every day count.
I heard he'll ask for a mate blessing if he wins.
I think it's possible.
Not with his girl, but her sister. Imagine.
I heard he'll ask for a mate blessing if he wins, but not with his girl, but her sister. Imagine.
I keep wanting to listen to what everyone's saying. That makes it hard for me to talk. Well, no one else is here. Oh, I can talk to these guys again, but I do think that it's possible we'll be getting different focuses. So that's what those headsets are called. Because when I was looking in... Where was I looking? Oh, I think it was when I was talking to the merchant and it showed me the weapons. Yeah, we could see videos of the weapons in action, right? And I'm pretty sure for one of the videos, I saw her wearing a different one. So maybe we'll be getting an upgrade later?
Your blessing was most illuminating. I've never seen its like. A rare gift, indeed.
But you don't believe in All-Mother, do you?
Usually the distance between our tribes shrouds Nora ways from Karja eyes. But here among you, I see a beauty that shines true. Perhaps Naaman is right after all, that the sun's light brightens all lands and all peoples.
Who's Naaman?
One of my brethren, who believes the sky is wide enough for the faiths of all tribes.
That's awesome! Very accepting.
Who is the Sun King you speak for?
His luminance Avad is the 14th king of the Radiant Line. His light envelops the sky and everything beneath it. He is the chosen of the sun. By his divine rule, we are given sight and purpose.
You speak highly of him. Do you know him well?
By his nature, he is unknowable and infallible. We are his instruments, not his companions. I have been in his presence, but we draw down our hoods so as not to behold his light directly.
He's the sun, he has total power, and no friends. That couldn't go wrong.
Wow, that sounded something like exactly what Chloe from Life is Strange would say. They share a voice actress, of course.
If your Sun Kings are so infallible, how do you explain the crimes of the last king?
Well, the Sun's glory is a great and brazen crown for a vessel as small as a man. If the vessel is flawed, indeed in the burial caves, one can see the skulls of the past kings are cracked, trialed and fired in the Sun's kiln. That can be too much for any man to bear, even a ruler of men.
So the sun can make bad choices like anyone else.
Oh, no, no, no.
Has there ever been a sun queen?
Many wives and consorts, of course. Or, oh, you mean for the sun to choose a queen? This has not happened.
Why not?
The sun is masculine, of course, and so would choose its heirs thus.
It's a light in the sky. I've never seen anything dangling from it. I don't know if you've noticed, but women run things around here.
Well, Avad took a woman as captain of his vanguard, the first to hold such an honor.
You mean Aaron's sister, Ursa. From what he told me, she sounds formidable.
Oh, formidable indeed. A woman and an outsider as well.
She might make a fine sun queen, given a chance.
A sun queen? Oh, no, no.
Blasphemy.
No.
So, it looks like the Karja tribe, they might be more advanced than us in terms of maybe armor and stuff, but in some aspects, like respecting women. Maybe not the most up-to-date, but this new king guy, though, he did promote the other guy's sister to be the vanguard leader, so maybe things are changing for this tribe as well.
Who are you, Sun Priest?
I am the Reverend Irid. The glory of the Karja is the sun's glory, reflected. We Sun Priests are but glimmers of its great light.
You just said a lot, but you didn't tell me anything.
My apologies. My duty is to carry out the will of the sun by serving its emissary among us, the Sun King. I comfort those who walk by the light of day, and I travel to those in far reaches whom the light barely touches, bearing warmth.
So you live in Meridian?
I do. Where better to mark the sun's divine passage than where the sandstone glows in the light of its passing? I was raised in the mesa's great shade, its wild bird markets and metal cellars, spices and colored silks.
Sounds impressive.
Oh, you should behold it. And you can if you make the journey. At His Luminance's order, we have flung its gates open to all.
Any Nora who leaves the sacred land becomes an exile. But hey, who knows where I'll end up. Did you come all this way just to deliver your Sun King's speech?
It is my duty, and also my honor, to carry the light of atonement to those we overshadowed and wronged. I swallowed my fear, but it reemerged. I am glad Erend Van Guardsman made this journey. He is my shield, a good man.
Why were the Karja at war with the Nora?
Under the 13th Sun King, the Karja had no peace with any tribe. His Luminance has sent those days to dusk. We must renew the light that binds us, though few volunteered to come here.
The Nora scare you. They're good at making people feel unwelcome.
It's said one soldier died for every Nora taken alive.
Whoa.
But I see you can be as calm as you are fierce.
She's snarky.
This has been illuminating, but I should get going.
You have already been blessed, but may the dawn find you, the day warm you, and the dusk have light to guide your path.
Thank you. Thank you. All right, buddy. You still want to talk?
That blessing wasn't bad. Nice and short, anyway. But I know a half dozen Asaram tinkers who could put on a better fireworks show. Oops. I hope I'm not throwing a wet blanket on your sacred ritual. It was nice. Really.
Tell me about Olin again.
Oh, no.
He's not scrounging. No. He's scouting. Exactly the skills you want the man guiding your... I've known him for a few...
Nothing else then. Oh, this one? Meridian? Did we ask about that?
Just how big is Meridian? What's it like?
Where do I even start? My tribesmen are masters of the forge, the best tinkers in the world. But when it comes to building, the Karja have us beat. The city soars over a canyon with more bridges than the Nora have roads and buildings tall as mountains. And across the valley stands the spire, like a blade thrust into the sky reflecting the sun. You really owe it yourself to see it. So consider that a challenge. Or an invitation.
Wait, hang on. So the priest guy is from the Karja tribe, but this guy is an Asaram. Whenever I talked about the Karja tribe having nice armor or looking like medieval soldiers, who I really mean is the Asaram tribe.
I want to ask you about something you said before.
Ask away.
Just kidding.
Yeah, well, good luck in that proving thing. Maybe I'll see you in Meridian someday. Who knows?
Hello, Matriarch.
Aloy, now that the blessing has been made, you and I finally have a moment to speak. I hope the ceremony wasn't too unpleasant for you, given your circumstances.
No, thank you. Thank you for making me a lantern.
I can't say it was comfortable, but I could see the beauty of the ritual, even so.
It takes a generous heart, Aloy, to commend a ritual that venerates all that you were denied.
All I'm saying is that it didn't bother me. I have bigger things to worry about than hearing the Nora mumble about their mothers.
I see. I imagine you must have questions for me then.
That's straight.
Why was I made an outcast at birth, Tirsa? What crime could I have committed even before I was born?
Aloy, this is not a question I can answer.
Why not? It's simple enough. And what about my mother? Is she here tonight, watching me? Or is she dead? Is she here? Or nowhere?
I am sure your mother is here with us, if only in spirit.
That's not really an answer, is it? Just so you know, Tirsa, the reason I'm here is to get answers. Real ones. And when I win the proving, I will demand them.
I know, Aloy. I would expect nothing less.
Is she not telling me because she doesn't know? Or is she not telling me because she does know and she just doesn't want to tell me?
It surprises me the tribe lets outcasts run in the proving. It's not like the Nora to be so hospitable.
It has always been law that any child outcast has this right, as a means to rejoin the tribe. So far as I know, however, you are the first ever to exercise this right.
I'm not surprised. I doubt many outcast children survive long enough in the wilds to come of age.
Mm-hmm.
I think, rather, it is because child outcasts are so rare. In all my years, I've only known of one other child who was cast out. A boy of 13, who killed his mother. But at the proving 5 years later, he did not appear.
No, I'd be surprised if he survived very long on his own.
But at least he had a chance. Other tribes would have simply executed him. It may be hard for you to accept, Aloy. But the practice of shunning is, relatively speaking, humane.
Oh, is it? Try it out for 18 years, Tirsa, and then let me know what you think.
It might be humane if we did something to deserve it, but as far as we know, were we born to the wrong mother? Or like, why did we get cast out? We don't know why. That's what makes it inhumane.
What about Rost? Why was he made an outcast?
So, he never told you?
He said he swore an oath never to speak of it.
Yes. As did I, and the other matriarchs. I'm sorry, Aloy. But Rost's past is another secret I must keep from you.
What else is new?
She's so full of bitterness.
Rost told me that matriarchs don't just lead the tribe. What else do you do?
We teach, offer counsel, give blessings. When necessary, we judge. Our only concern is the welfare of the tribe. Among our number this year, we count 3 high matriarchs and some 30 lesser matriarchs.
What's the difference?
Matriarchs are grandmothers with 2 generations of living progeny.
Oh.
But a high matriarch is a great-grandmother with 3 or more generations to her name. Thus,
what?
Do we speak for generations, lending our opinions weight. The high matriarchs most of all.
So, the more children you have, the more authority you get? I guess that's one way to decide who leads a tribe.
Why would there be any other?
I am so happy that Aloy is really saying everything I think of. Like, every time someone says something questionable, she just says right out, "Thank you for speaking my mind," really. Who is Lanzra?
Why does Lanzra hate me so much?
She is a woman of extreme
opinions. Oh, the other matriarch.
More than that, I cannot say.
It's not my fault that I was born, or that the matriarchs decided to cast me out.
I side with you in this matter, but there are differences of opinion, and any vote of the high matriarchs requires a majority.
I guess that's that.
I should be going. I'm sorry if I've been too harsh. It's just, I've wanted answers for so long.
I know, child. You're not the only one who's waited years for this day. I will be praying for your success.
Thank you. You know, I thought this tribe was kind of nice that it held women in such high regard, but it totally... like, they hold women in high regard not because they think people should be equal. It just happens to be that way. There's no merit to this. Okay. I'm wondering a little bit though. In the Nora tribe, we have the All Mother, but as far as I know, the All Mother is kind of like, it's kind of like Mother Nature. It's not really any one person, but the Karja tribe, they have the Sun God. The Sun King, who is an actual person. Do we have an equivalent of the Sun King in the Nora tribe? Because I feel like the matriarchs might be a step below that. Are we finally gonna start doing this? Enter the Hunter's Lodge, where the aspirants will sleep before the night. Before the night, before the proving. Okay.
Too much romance, not enough fist fights this time.
Can I find a save point again, by the way? I would love to save. It's a Hunter's Lodge. One last save for good luck.